Hello. Welcome to how to create a network storage server on a virtual server. I use TrueNAS Scale to create a network storage server on Proxmox. I add more physical hard drives to the virtual machine to increase the storage size. You go to the home page and download the latest installer. Then you upload it to the Proxmox server as above. I create a new network storage server. The physical hard drives will be added after the operating system installation is completed. You follow these steps to create a new virtual machine. I use this virtual machine as a network storage server. You browse to the operating system installer that was just uploaded in the previous step. I use most of the default settings to create a new virtual machine. You can customize the hardware to optimize performance. Next, I install the operating system for the virtual machine. The steps are the same as installing on a physical computer with only one hard drive. You are asked to create a new administrator account and you should write it down for use in step after. After completing the operating system installation, I shut down the virtual machine to add traditional hard drives. A network storage server cannot use only one hard drive. The operating system is installed on one hard drive and the data is stored or backed up on other hard drives. In this case, I add two new traditional hard drives to the virtualization server. You make sure the virtualization server has detected the traditional hard drives. On my virtualization server, there is a solid-state hard drive and two traditional hard drives. I will find a way to connect the virtual machine to these traditional hard drives. On the Proxmox homepage, there are instructions for us to do that. You just follow those instructions. Each hard drive will have a different identifier, no two are the same. You open a command window and list the identifiers of the hard drives. You should write down the identifier of each hard drive to use in the next steps. I have three hard drives and each hard drive has a different identifier. I am only interested in two traditional hard drives. Because I install the virtualization operating system on a solid-state hard drive. So I don't use it on a network storage server. Each virtual machine also has a different identifier. In this case, my virtual machine has the identifier 100. If I create the next virtual machines, it is identified as 101, 102. I use the virtual machine identifier, the hard drive identifier to connect the network storage server to the physical hard drives. I connect the virtual machine to two traditional hard drives in turn. Each hard drive connects to the virtual machine via a different SCSI interface. This interface is numbered in order of 0, 1, 2. I connect the first traditional hard drive to the SCSI-1 interface. As you can see, the virtual machine has an additional hard drive. Similarly, I connect the second traditional hard drive to the SCSI-2 interface. You update the hard drive identifier to add hard drives to the virtual machine. After completing, I check the virtual machine hard drive. On my virtual machine, there are 3 hard drives in total. You can add more hard drives if you want. You make sure the virtual machine boots from the hard drive that has the operating system installed. I start the virtual machine to configure the basic steps. After the boot is complete, an access address appears. You use it for remote access. On the browser, I access using the IP address. I use the admin password set in the previous step to log into the management page. The first thing I care about is whether the server has detected the traditional hard drives or not. As you can see, the server has detected 2 traditional hard drives. This is a virtual machine but using physical hard drives. This virtual machine works like a network storage server. Next, I set up storage, create a new account and share resources over the network. These are the steps to build a network storage server on the virtualization server. I installed TrueNAS Scale on Proxmox to do that. Thank you for watch. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I wipe the hard drives before configuring the storage. With 2 hard drives, I choose 2-way mirror storage. This is a way to protect data if one of the 2 hard drives fails. With more hard drives, you have more options for configuring data redundancy. Next, I create a new account. I use this account to access the shared resource over the network. Next, I create a new folder and share it over the network. You can upload or download files from other computers on the local network. I change the ownership from the administrator account to the newly created account. I do this to allow that account to access, add, edit, delete. folder access successful. I create a new file and upload another file to test the result. Good luck.